title today. It's a very unusual video that I would make, but today I'm going to make a video of my life and stuff I did or things I regret doing on my channel. So today, make sure you subscribe to this channel, leave a like, share it. The reason that I want you to subscribe, because and then it may help you, or it may help people who you know, any loved ones who are going through this, or people who, you know, you want to reach out to them. So if you subscribe to this channel, I will be bringing some more out of this, and I will be starting a campaign about bullying, because I got bullied when I was a child. So yeah, so make sure you stay tuned. So my name is Jack Sharrett. I was born in Billinge, Wigan, on September the 3rd, 1998. I lived in Bolton, I lived in Wigan since I was born until the year 2006. In 2006, we left Wigan, but I went to primary school in Wigan, which I had a crap time there because I got bored there too. So what year would I have been in 2006? So probably like in year two, something like that, yeah. Because when I went to St. James in 2003, yeah. So in Wigan, in Goulburn, I was in year two when I left. So I was quite thankful that I left that, because I went to the same school that my mother and my auntie went to when they were a child. So yeah, so I kind of left there back in 2006, moved to a new primary school, which was in Bolton, because we kind of moved house. So we live in the same house from 2006. It's haunted. That's probably the haunted videos I've posted on. It's the same house. I have witnessed a lot of paranormal or abnormal stuff in this room, actually. So something might happen while I'm recording this video. So talk to it, isn't. So anyway, so let's get back to the story. So I moved into a new primary school after I moved house. Back in 2006. Yes, I went to a new primary school, which is actually around the corner from my house now. So I'm not going to tell you that's where it is, because I currently live in there, so I don't want to start me and all that. Yeah. So I went to there. I hoped to not get bored. My wish was to never get bored again, because when free bullying back in Goulburn, my dream and wish was to make friends, so when I'm older, we can get absolutely smashed out of our minds and just enjoy life. You know, when lads holidays, you know, like all stuff that you do back, you know, at this age, like 21, 22. So my dream was to, you know, make friends, have a girlfriend, because I'm still single, as a criminal. So my dream was to make friends and basically just do lad things, you know, like enjoy life. So I went and moved to my new primary school, which was in 2006. I was in year three. So we kind of lived through the whole summer in Goulburn. So then in September we kind of moved into a new primary. So anyway, first started primary, I was getting to know people, like, hello, my name's Jack, da da da. Like, I was telling them that I moved all the way from Goulburn, so ready to, you know, settle into a new school, told them that I moved house and all that. And then, I tried to make friends with some people, and I was chatting to some guy, and then it started off with this guy, like, This dude's a bit weird. You know, I was young and because I went to a weird primary, weird. I was in year three at the time. You know, I was hoping to make friends, stuff like that, because my dream was obviously to make friends. So then So then it started off because this guy said, "Oh, this guy's a bit weird. Like, why are we even talking to him? Like, I was weird. Like, I'm not gonna admit that. Probably most 11-year-olds are weird. Like, no 11-year-old is not weird." So then, no, actually, no. Year three, no, wasn't. I was 8. Yeah, not many 8-year-olds are not weird. Like, every 8-year-old is probably the same. Like, you are a bit daft, silly, you know, weird stuff like that. Obviously, I was quite weird because I was 8-year-old. I haven't grown up yet. Just started life. No, nothing else to say about that other than I was weird. Like, just coming down below if you was a weird one back in when you were 8, because I bet you every person who comments down below was like, yeah, I was like that. I was like, no doubt everyone was not weird back when they were 8. So then the teacher was like, right, we're gonna go into groups, just make friends with Jack. Jack started today, da da da. So then we first started, so then we was in subjects and all that, and I don't really want to put this out to the whole world, but I have to, because I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, you know, I've got a stutter. Every time I make a video, I start stuttering away. I was like da 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 da. I've got moderate learning difficulties, and yeah, I can't help that. I wish that I never had that. I wish I was like a normal person, and I do what normal people do, like my age, because I don't want to miss out what people do at my age. Obviously, my parents are in the background, you know, downstairs, you know, doing what they're ever doing, and I sit upstairs with my mates. But my parents are sat down. My parents are in the same pub, but they're like sat downstairs, like somewhere. So if anything happens, they're like kind of like they're at the scene like straight away, like that. So I obviously go to a high school. No, I don't. I go to a college with people who have the same thing. If you saw me in real life, you wouldn't know I've got anything wrong with me, apart from when I start talking, because I start stuttering away, which is a bit bad. And I just wish I wish that I was in a life where I was normal, I could make friends straight away, stuff like that. And yeah, so I was back in primary. Teachers kind of like got us into these groups, you know, getting to know you. So obviously these people's like, oh, I'm Lauren. Oh, hello, I'm Charlotte. Hello, I'm Kieran. Kieran was a prick, he was. And then it was kind of going into groups, and Kieran Richmond, he was the biggest prick. He was the biggest prick ever. So then he was like, he's a bit strange. Like, why have you joined this school for? And I was like, oh, I've just moved house. I've moved from Wigan. And then he started saying to me, he's weird, but he's also a pie eater. And he started laughing, and that's probably when it's first started off, saying you're a pie eater. And obviously I've got a surname of Sharrett, stuff like that. People used to call me Jack Sharrett, a carrot. You probably get the pitch. I can't say the full thing because it's, might get tagged on YouTube and all that, might get demonetized. Anyway, I was walking home from my first day at school. They weren't as bullying me yet because they didn't know me yet. So, and then as the weeks and months got gone by, this girl came in. We was kind of roughly around the same age, because we was obviously in the same class. I was the oldest by a year. I was 12, she was 11. We kind of got to know each other, saying, oh, my name's Beth.
And I said, "Oh, my name's Jack." And kind of got along, and then kind of turned into like girlfriend and boyfriend. That's how you called it. You kind of like boyfriend and girlfriend, stuff like that. So we used to hang about. We used to go to park, and then we used to like go to park and have a race, stuff like that. That's what you do, you know, back when you're a kid, you do kid stuff and like stuff like that. And then these group of lads who came on the who was it in my class, they came to the park saying, "What are you doing on this park for? Like, this is our territory. This like you need to leave, otherwise you get one of these up your face." So then, I was like, "Well, we don't have to move. We were here first. Like, can we not just? Can we not just go on park and just like just? I mean, we might not be able to talk to each other, but we can just stay on the park, you know, like mind our own businesses." And then they'd be like, "No, you have to leave the park, or else you get this up your foot, like you get punched in the fucking face." And then and I kind of thought, right, these lads have been serious. So then I left with my kind of god girlfriend back in not back in that year. So then a week and probably like 5 weeks later, I used to spend a lot of time around my gran and grandma's, because my auntie Tasha, she used to live at my aunt's. Because she was like, I think she was 21, so probably same age as I am now. She's 20 or so. She was 20, 21. She used to live at my nan's. I used to go around there, make cakes, cupcakes, chocolate cakes. You know, we used to make all that together, stuff like that. She's basically like a sister to me, because we've done everything together, stuff like that. And we used to make cupcakes and all that, and yeah, just you know, make cakes and all that. I don't know why I keep repeating myself. So anyway, we was in the garden, you know, playing football, and then we had a knock at the gate, like, and then like, we kind of went to the gate, and then kind of went, "Who is it?" And then they were like, "It's Kieran." I was like, "Kieran?" They were like, "Kieran Richmond." I was like, "All right, do you want to come in then?" And then he was like, "Well, you better not say no, otherwise you get a fist thrown at your face." So then my auntie heard it, and she's like, "Oh, come in." Anyway, and he was like, "Whose house is this then?" I was like, "Oh, it's my gran and grandma's house." "Well, can we go inside then and have a look?" And he was like, "Yeah." Well, I said, "You won't come to the forest with us, because we can have a walk around the forest, you know, get to know each other properly." And I was like, "Nah, I'm fine here, thanks." So then my auntie said, "Jack, do you wanna go to the forest with him?" And I went, "No, like, you don't know these guys." And then I said, like, "No." So then my auntie were like, "No, I didn't want to go out with you." So then she said, "Well, would you?" So and then my auntie said, "Oh, can you leave the house, please?" So then they were like, "No." I was like, "Right, if you don't leave in 5 seconds, we are phoning the police." So then they kind of left. We didn't realise that the front door was unlocked. We had no idea the front door was unlocked. Me and my auntie were upstairs, because we had this karaoke machine. We used to kind of like sing into it, stuff like that, and it kind of like sung everything back to us. And we had the front door open, stuff like that. I have a bit of a problem. Yeah. So we had the front door open, and we kind of found the door locked. It's a bit of wind. So then we had some walking in the lounge saying, "Whoa." So then I kind of thought, right, I'm gonna go downstairs. Sounds like Kieran and Owen. they were both pricks too. And so then I went down and I was like, what are you doing here? After we've just told you, you were not allowed in the house. So then my auntie came down saying, what's going on here? And then I was like, well, they just walked in. So then they were like, front door open. So then my auntie was like, front door was open, but then it doesn't mean that you have to walk in. You have not had permission to come in the house. So then they said, we really want Jack to come to the forest. So then my auntie was like, no, he's not going with you. So can you leave? Can you leave the house? So then they were like, no, we're not leaving the house. So then my auntie were like, no, you are leaving the house. Or we're going to phone the police. So then they kind of got the picture, left the house, and they're like, we really won't go up the forest with Jack. We won't make friends with you. You know, acting that fake, you know, pathetic thing. I know what you're up to. Because obviously, once you take me into a forest and leave me, I was stranded in the forest.
I'm the strongest motherfucker in the world, bitch!